In God's house. Amen. We thank God for all of you. We certainly hope that you won't go back out the door the same way that you came in, because I believe that when we come to church, we ought to get something that's going to help us. Amen. If it don't do nothing but help us grow an inch, at least you were an inch better than you walked in the door. Amen. So if you don't get nothing but a little bit that help you get an inch better, at least you know I'm moving up. But I'm not going down. Amen. Sometimes you might feel like you have to stand still, but you might not want to stand still too long. Amen. You got to keep on moving. I'll say amen. We got to run this race. Didn't tell you got to walk.
Amen.
But you got to run this race with patience. That was set for. You got to run. It's something about it now. Amen. So I hope that you'll get something somewhere from the beginning of the service to the ending of the service that'll help you get a little better, that'll strengthen you a little bit, that'll help you a little bit more, so that we all can be ready to go back to Jesus when he comes. If you got a problem, I hope you get it solved. Situation, I want to work it out for the people of God. Amen. Because you know, there's a lot of things that come up, but I can't stand there and preach and tell you you ain't going to have no trouble. Because I'll be lying.
Amen.
Reality is that you can have some trouble. Amen. You can have some suffering. You might go through some things. That's to be your walk as a saint of God. Amen. Jesus had trouble. The apostles had trouble. Amen. And we might have some trouble. But the thing is that if we stay focused and let God take care of it, you come out all right. Sometimes these things come to make us strong. You know, the devil, our enemy, I listened to Sister Martin, and she said the devil tells us he doesn't have nothing. You know, there's so much to thank God for. And I thought about the scripture. I started to write it down and tell the usher to come and give it to him. Amen. But the Bible said better is a look that a righteous man has. You might not have much. And sometimes the devil will tell you you don't have much when you got a whole lot going for you. You know that? The devil is always a liar. And sometimes the devil will tell you, you ain't got nothing going on for you. And let me tell you something. First of all, if you didn't have nothing going on for you, he wouldn't tell you that.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. If you didn't have something going on for you, he wouldn't tell you that. He tell you that to discourage you. He tell you that to make you look at, well, this thing. None of us may be where you want to be. But I tell you something. You know God done brought you from somewhere.
Yeah.
And if you keep on keeping on, whatever God got for you, you will get it.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah.
You'll get it now.
Yeah.
And one thing about you ain't got to make it happen. He said all these things, these blessings that come upon you and overtake you. It'll come to you when you're doing this thing right.
Yes.
God still believes. He's still holding to his word.
Oh yeah, yes he is.
That which is written is still coming to pass. It's still true. It's still real. So yeah, the devil's a lie. He tell you ain't nothing happening. Ain't nothing happening. He show you all of this. And you know, sometimes the devil, you know why some people make it hard on themselves. Now y'all know I got to preach what the Holy Ghost give me. Now, if I can't preach what the Holy Ghost give me, then I need to sit down. Whether you like it or not, amen. I don't get so in somebody that I can't preach. You know, some people, they get in the buddy-buddy system and something come up, they can't preach it. And the Holy Ghost tell them to preach it, they can't preach it. Because see, I can't preach it, but that's my buddy. I love everybody.
Yes.
Amen. But I'm gonna preach the word.
Yes.
I beat my wife, my sons know if they I had somebody one of my sons, somebody left. I said, yeah, I'm gonna preach what the Holy Ghost give me. I said, you in the road, then the Holy Ghost will run over you too.
Yes.
And that's a hypocrite that can preach to the saints and can't preach to the whole family member.
Amen.
God ain't got no preachers like that. Amen.
Amen.
Some preachers, they preach against airing, but when their daughters get up and want to wear them, they change the message. That's a hypocrite.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. They preach, during you and Eno, Sister Doc don't wear his wedding pants. But when their daughter want to wear them, they change it. Yeah. God ain't looking at your outward appearance. That's a hypocrite. Yeah. Yeah. I know I'm already going to get in trouble. Just for every time I get up here, I get in trouble. Amen. Yeah. Praise God. I get the praise. Nobody wants to fool with me. Yeah. Hallelujah, God. But that's all right. God, I tell somebody, God, send somebody to love you.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
That's all right. Thank God. And I'm going to have the people to give me. Amen. That's right. Some folks get themselves in trouble and make their battle hard. You know why? Because you're looking at Buddy Manchester's God. You're looking at Buddy Daniel's God. You're looking at Buddy James' God. And then you compare yourself with them. And you make your walk much more harder. Because you're looking at what they got. You're looking at what kind of job they got, what kind of car they driving, what kind of house they live in.
Amen.
They got this and I don't have that. Some of you, you know that old saying the world say, to keep up with the Joneses.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
And that makes your walk harder because you trying to keep up with what somebody else got.
Yes.
And that makes the devil fight you even more because you got your eyes on what they got, what they doing, what they driving. You know what I'm telling the truth from your life?
That's right.
Oh yes, that's what got some of them. You fighting in your mind because you looking at what somebody else got. Whenever you can come and focus on those little minute things, you know you ain't in the spirit.
Amen.
You're not in the spirit. And the devil using that to divert you from getting something that could help you to go through another day.
Yes.
That's right.
Whenever you can come to church and think things like that, this person here got on something new. You're looking too hard.
Amen.
And you ain't in the spirit.
Amen.
The spirit ain't worried about that.
Yeah.
Amen. Some folks make that fight much more hard. Stop making it harder for you. We got enough to fight already.
Oh,
then for you to go pick up unnecessary things
sure
to put on your plate to help
yeah
you. And that's what some of y'all doing. Amen.
Yeah.
That's what some of you doing. You trying to keep up with something, keep up with someone, and that's in your mind, and you fight and you're battling with that thing.
Jesus.
And the devil using that against you.
Yes.
Amen. You keep that, and that's how he can come up in here.
Yeah.
Jealousy come up in the church.
Yeah, man.
Malice will come up.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
If you got all that in your heart and mind, let me tell you something. You ain't going to heaven full of jealousy.
That's right.
Mm-mm.
Amen. You're not going to heaven full of jealousy.
Amen.
You're not going to heaven full of hate.
Yes.
Hallelujah to God.
That's right.
None of us going to heaven full of hate.
Yes.
That's a ticket to hell.
Yes,
it is.
Amen.
Yes.
You can't hate and go to heaven. Thank you, Jesus. This might not be a shout today, but it'll help your soul.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
It'll help your soul. It's not going to help you to be full of jealousy,
no,
full of hatred. The Bible says that's the work. Get me Galatians. Galatians 5:19. Amen. I'll give you my reference. You can sit down. Amen. Galatians 5:19. That's the Bible speaks about the works of the flesh.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
The works of the flesh.
Yes.
Amen. What the Bible says.
Amen.
Now the works of the flesh.
Amen. Yes.
There are works of the flesh.
Yes.
And there's works and fruit of the spirit.
Yes.
But the Bible says, now are the work of the flesh
are manifest.
Which
are these?
And in men are, which are these?
Amen. Adultery.
If you're living in adultery,
amen,
that's the work of the flesh.
Yes.
Some preachers don't preach this and they don't want
amen
to preach it. But let me tell you something. You can't have somebody's husband or somebody's wife.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Don't tell people a lie that the Spirit gave you somebody's husband.
No.
You are lying.
Yes.
Yes.
You know, some folks go and get in the Spirit. Oh, the Spirit led me to you.
Jesus.
And the Spirit don't believe, our Spirit will leave
you.
But the Holy Ghost don't leave you to nobody else husband.
Amen.
And nobody else wife.
Amen.
And the Holy Ghost wives. And the Holy Ghost know how to respect each other.
Yes.
Yes.
Some folks think that, you know, you ought to respect somebody else.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
You ought to respect that man wife.
Yes.
Yeah. and want attention from somebody else's husband.
That's right.
There's a spirit working in there.
That's right.
Amen. Oh, yes. Something wrong with that man that got a wife, but then he wants attention from some other sister. There's a spirit working in there. That's not a dog. Amen. Help me, Holy Ghost. Preach from the minister. Spirit to get up, but it's not of God. Amen. Adultery. Fornication. Yes, we still go preach against fornication. Amen. Oh, yes. And some of you think you're slick, but you're not slicker than God.
And I look at the person, I saw the person that they're getting with. You know what the Spirit told me? The Spirit said they own birth control pills. And that's why they're getting fat.
Jesus! Yeah.
Y'all excuse me now.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
You know, I didn't get up to prove Jesus in it. Amen. And I got the preach what the Holy Ghost give me. And I ain't worried about whether you like it or not. Because long as I do God's will, He can look out for me. And I dare you in the Holy Ghost tomorrow. What the Bible says. Adultery and fornication.
Uncleanness.
Looking at all kind of things.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
Don't tell me you can pray like that. You can't pray with that stuff in your mind. That's why some of us can't get no victory. Got them dry prayers. Because you're buying up. The internet got you buying up. Them phones going to them websites got you buying up. I can look at some of you sometime and see you buying up.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah to God. But now you ought to want to be free in God. Adultery, fornication,
uncleanness.
Some people do some very unclean things. But let me tell you something. Uncleanness, the Bible speaks about it. Hallelujah to God. Uncleanness. Somebody know. You know. Amen. Uncleanness. Hallelujah to God. A man ought not treat his wife like she's a street woman. Help the Holy Ghost. And a woman ought not treat her husband like he's a street man. Amen. Uncleanness! Come on. That's shifting. You know what that means? Sexual sight, exciting desire.
Amen.
Look how I walk by you.
Oh, Lord.
Yeah.
That God can get your attention.
Yeah.
Amen.
Come on. Idolatry. That internet can be your idolatry.
Amen.
Get on that internet, and let me tell you something. The devil got a spirit in that computer. And time will go by so fast. Before you know, you'll be on the computer 4 hours. And it went by fast. But let me say, let somebody preach 4 hours. Let me preach 4 hours. Let me get close to 4 hours. They'll have a few choice words for me. They might not tell me.
Amen.
But they can talk about it. Wow.
Amen.
It don't take that much gospel to save the world. But the way you're talking, I might just go 10 because you ain't there yet.
Oh, yeah.
Amen.
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 Lord, you got some things now. Idolatry. Come on.
Witchcraft.
Witchcraft.
Oh, yeah.
Who's in the church has some foolishness? I put them someday working in witchcraft. You know that's not God.
Yeah.
Chicken dust. That's not the devil.
Amen.
Witchcraft. Roots. And going to play the Reverend Mother Christian. You see them signs out there? With the hand. Hand out there. Come and let me tell you. I need to go in there and tell them something. Come and let me tell you. Then they charge you. Charge you for lying.
Amen.
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 Witchcraft.
That's right.
I heard somebody told me one time, say somebody lost a pot or something. Said they went to the person, tell them, say, help me find a pot. And you say you can tell me who got the stuff. So you tell them, say, it's because you, I'll tell you, Spirit show me where it is. Cost $175. First, if I ain't gonna pay that much for the pot, you'd be better to buy a new pot. I laugh. I said, well, that's right. If you got to pay $175 to locate the one and you ain't paid, go buy a new pot. And save the $175. You might get it for $9.99. So you got $100-something, you can keep it. See, that's why I know they're foolish. That's foolishness. And let me tell you something, if somebody prayed up in God, you ain't got to go to no work.
Amen.
Because what you want done, God can do it.
Amen.
Hey, why are you going to the root worker? Somebody on my job bothered me. Tell God to bother me and tell God to deal with me. And save you $175.
Amen.
Read.
Witchcraft.
Hatred.
Amen.
Let me tell you something, you're not going to hell full of hatred. Hatred! That's the work of the flesh.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Hatred! Amen. Y'all got that in your mind?
Amen.
Folks hate one another and say, I'm going to heaven. But you done missed it? No. You done missed it. Hatred! Hallelujah to God. Come on.
Variance.
Variance. Always you find somebody that always got a different opinion. Opinion. Always. You say right, they say wrong.
Oh, yeah.
You say up, they say down.
Yeah.
That's a spirit.
Amen.
Always on the controversy side.
Yes.
Amen.
You better watch that spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
Variance.
Emulation.
Emulation. Trying to outdo somebody else.
Amen.
Some folks try to outdo somebody else.
Amen.
I'll outdo you. You come in here with a new outfit on. I'm coming with one next Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
You ain't in the church for that.
Amen.
Amen. That's foolishness.
Amen.
Emulation.
Wrath.
Wrath.
Strife.
Strife.
Jesus.
Sedition. Sedition.
Heresies.
Envies.
Envy.
If you can't get into heaven like that, go ahead.
Murders.
Murders.
Drunkenness.
Drunkenness.
Reveling.
Reveling.
And such like.
All right, you that say you can't party, you look that word up, Reverend, talking about loud festivities.
kind of like the fair. I knew y'all would like that. Go and check up on me now. I'm going to see what that word means.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Loud. Festivities. Sound like the fair. Sound like the disco. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
You know how some of us, I see in the Bible where we can't go to the disco. I see in the Bible. You know, some people want to see everything in the Bible.
Yes.
They want to see God sitting on our pet pew. Is that a word? Maybe we're supposed to sit on stools. You know, we got that spirit in the church now. That you got to show me in the word. I see, I will fall and I will line up, but you got to show me. When they go to asking all them questions, something in them not right. But you know, the Holy Ghost will accept what being preached. Holy Ghost, I said the word. But some, tell me, show me where we is all right to sit on a padded pew. So I don't see in the word. Sometimes I don't see where we can't smoke. I don't see that in the word. When the Bible says, cleanse yourself from the filthiness of the flesh.
Amen.
Boy, it's in there.
Amen.
You want to smoke?
Amen.
I don't see where the Bible says we can't drink.
Jesus.
I don't see the Bible say where we just can't drink. The Bible says strong drink.
Amen.
Praise. And wine is a mark.
Amen.
And the ones that do it are deceived. But I want to know, show me why, I don't see that. I don't see why we can't go to the fair. Relevance.
Amen.
That's why you can't go.
Amen.
That's why you ought to stay away from them things.
Amen.
Oh, y'all be back quiet. Thank you.
Amen.
That don't stop me from talking.
Amen.
Get quiet. You think that stopped me? Uh-huh.
Amen.
God might give me extra little to get. I might get all my good. That don't stop me now. Hallelujah, God.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You don't got quiet. We want to go to the bed.
Yeah.
Get some elephant ears.
Amen.
Oh,
Jesus. Yeah. Amen.
Oh, I just don't like the element. I done planned to start. It's coming up now. He done been. I didn't plan to go one day.
Yeah.
And then you go out there and get her and scared to come back and ask for prayer. The bitch said, daughter, son, what happened to you? When is happening? Fine up. Hey. All right. And you go down into the state fair. Holy Ghost and tell me balance. Hallelujah to God.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes there's a good prayer to pray. Say, Lord, take the world out of me. I was praying one time. I said, Lord, take the world out of me.
Yeah.
You know, you can pray the prayer and certain things you don't want to do.
Amen.
God can fix you that you don't want to do certain things. Certain things you don't have an interest in. It. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah. Hallelujah to God. Read for me.
Revelation.
Yes.
And such life.
And such life.
Which I tell you before.
Which I tell you before.
As I also told you.
As I past. Told you in time past.
They which do
such things.
Shall not inherit the kingdom of
God. So if you do any of these things, the Bible says, you shall not inherit the kingdom. Come on.
Of God.
Of God. Come with love.
That's right.
You know, I was listening to Sister Mary Testimony. How she talked about love. Now, you know that was a task.
Amen.
She said, I see my husband with his girlfriend.
Oh my God.
That's right.
I see her. I see her with his girlfriend there. She got to kiss him.
Amen.
And go on. Now that takes some love.
Amen.
So you didn't want that?
Oh, yes.
That's right.
That's my man.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, y'all got them hats on, but y'all know you're a fight.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
You got them head covers.
True.
But some of you be fighting.
Yeah.
That's mama.
Yeah, yeah.
Amen.
Oh yeah. Some of you say now, I'm not like Sister Mary.
Uh-uh.
But I tell you what, Sister Mary and Sister Lancaster, you got the same Holy Ghost.
Amen. What?
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Oh, yeah.
Some of us struggling with something today.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
But God ain't kidding.
Yeah.
Be honest, Lord.
Yeah.
Say, Lord, I'm struggling with something. Hallelujah. You know this best to help us.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I feel like sitting down, but actually I feel like getting on my knees and telling everybody to get on the knees.
Yeah.
And tell God, just wash me.
Yeah.
Wash us, Lord. Wash us, Lord. You're struggling with something. You're dealing with something. And you need God help. What the Bible says.
Acknowledge.
Acknowledge.
My transgression.
You ought to acknowledge that you're struggling with something. God can help you. God can help you. God can help you. One time I began to say, I said, Lord, search me.
Yes.
And I stopped and I said, Lord, it don't need you to search me, you already know what's in me.
Yeah.
I said, Lord, if anything, man, you take it out.
That's right.
Yeah. Amen. Yeah. Don't think I can get up here and preach to you and don't check me out.
Amen.
I keep prayer on me too.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
I keep prayer on me too.
Oh, yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
I don't care where you are. Up there, out there, under there, wherever you are, but you ought to ask God to wash you. Somebody need to be washed today. Somebody's struggling with something, and you need to be washed. Amen. Come on. Acknowledge that you got an issue. Acknowledge that you're struggling. Come on.
Yes, sir. Against thee and thee only.
Against thee and thee only.
Well, I sin.
Have I sinned?
And done this evil
in thy sight. In thy sight. Listen to that David talking to God. He said, Lord, I've done this thing in your sight.
That the mind.
The Bible says,
yes,
he that covereth his sin shall not prosper.
Amen.
Some of you need to come up from under that cover.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Hallelujah, God.
Yeah.
Come on from under that cover.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. God, you must up under there anyway.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Come on. He that covered his sin
oh,
shall
yeah.
not prosper. Read from this.
Yes, sir. That thou mightest be justified.
That thou mightest be justified.
Oh, when thou speakest.
When thou speakest.
And declare.
And declare.
When thou judgest.
When thou judgest.
Behold.
Behold.
I was shapen.
I
in iniquity.
David talking to God.
Oh, yeah.
Said, Lord, I was shapen. In what?
Iniquity.
In iniquity.
And in sin.
And in sin.
Did my mother conceive?
Did my mother conceive?
That's right. Behold.
That's why everybody got to repent.
Amen.
That we were born in the sin.
Yeah.
And everybody under the sun got to repent. Come on.
That's right. Behold.
Behold.
Thou desirest truth.
Thou desirest truth.
In the inward part.
In the inward part.
And in the hid part.
Deacon, you work on you.
Yeah.
Work on you.
Yeah.
Don't worry about what nobody else doing. Yeah. Work on you.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You know when God come back, he ain't gonna ask you about
Hallelujah.
Steve.
Yeah.
He ain't gonna ask you about Maya.
Yeah.
He ain't gonna ask you about Sister Lucky.
Yeah.
Oh,
no.
He ain't gonna ask you about Rick Collins doing.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah. Yeah.
Sometimes work on this, but this person need to do this.
Yes.
And that person need to do
yes,
that.
Sir.
The Bible tell you to save yourself.
That's right.
Some of us in hell worried about somebody else.
Yes, sir.
Some of us to lose our soul worried about somebody else.
Yes.
Hallelujah. God. You got one soul to save.
Hallelujah.
You save your own self.
Hallelujah.
Work on your own self.
Hallelujah
to God. Come on.
Yes, sir. Desires truth.
Thou desirest truth.
In the inward parts.
In the inward part.
And in the hidden part.
Sister, let me tell you something. The devil is a liar, Sister Martin. Amen. Amen. I see him sometimes. He tried to bring a whole state of depression upon you.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah to God.
Mm-hmm.
But let me tell you something. The devil is a liar.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
The devil is a liar.
Yeah.
The devil is a liar. Yeah. Yeah. Nothing.
Yeah.
Amen. Tell him thank you, Jesus, anyway.
Yeah.
Trying to bring a spirit of depression down.
Yeah.
Amen. But the devil is a liar.
Yeah.
And he comes to you, tell him, thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.
You say that, tell him, thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.
And you get the victory.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
What the inward part.
And in the hidden part.
In the hidden part.
Thou shalt make me to know wisdom.
To know wisdom.
That's right.
Come on.
Purge me.
Purge me.
With hyssop.
Tell God to purge you. Hallelujah to God. Tell God to purge you.
Purge me.
Hallelujah to God. Purge me.
With hyssop.
Purge me.
That's right.
With hyssop.
And I shall be clean.
Ain't nothing wrong with you asking God to purge. Tell him to purge.
Yes, sir.
You know it's a bad thing when folks think that. Well, I don't want nobody to know I need to be purged.
Mm.
You're going to heaven, going to hell looking good.
Mm.
That's what some folks. I don't want to go before the church because people could think I ain't saved. Mm. Well, when you ain't up in hell, they could know you wasn't saved.
Yeah.
Purge me!
Purge me with hyssop!
You really need that God to purge!
Yes.
Purge!
Amen. Yes.
Purge!
Hallelujah to God!
Hallelujah to God! Purge me!
Yes, sir,
so you got something you need God to purge.
Yes.
You can sit in your seat right now and say, Lord, purge me.
Yes,
my heart needs to be purged.
That's right.
My mind needs to be purged.
Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah to God!
Yes.
My spirit needs to be purged.
That's right.
Purge me!
Yes, sir.
Purge me, Lord.
Amen.
Come on.
Purge me with hyssop.
Purge me with hyssop.
And I shall be clean.
I shall be clean.
Wash me.
Wash me.
And I shall be whiter than snow.
Ask God to wash you. God know how to wash you. Cleaner than anything else. Wash me, Lord. Come on.
I shall be whiter than snow.
Thou shalt be whiter than snow. That's why some of us can't have no joy. And ain't got no gladness.
Amen.
Cause you got so much dirt up in there.
That's right.
Hallelujah, God. You get too much dirt in your gas.
Amen.
That car ain't going for.
Amen.
Oh no.
Amen.
Get trash in your gas. It'll stop popping. That's why some of our life is popping. Pop it. There's something in there. But you got a chance today to ask God to purge you. And when you get purged, and when you get cleaned up, the Bible says you can have some joy.
Hallelujah.
What is the next one?
To hear joy.
Make me to have joy.
And gladness.
And gladness.
Yes, sir.
When you get loose, you can praise God. But you keep your mouth closed. Amen. I don't care if they made a mistake in the church and the whole church know about it. Some of you ain't got no wisdom. You talk everything. Telling people business. You know the Bible speak about busybodies in other men's mouths. That's not of God. The Bible said, Lord, I cover a multitude of sins. I'm sure Sister Mary not telling her husband every night, I remember when you had that girlfriend on the corner. And if she's doing this, you're wrong.
Amen.
Why is the Lord, you went to admire testimony, now you rebuking her. I'm going to tell the truth. If she bring it up, she's wrong.
Amen.
She was right on how she went about it the first time. But if she bringing it up now, she's wrong.
Amen.
You sisters that got husbands that made mistakes, don't remind him every day. You get mad. You know how some folks are, they get mad. Something happened today. They get mad and they go all the way back to everything that they can remember you done since the day you came out your mother womb. They bring that up. The Bible says you wicked.
Amen.
Tell me the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Wicked! Don't bring it up. Leave it where it is. That ain't the issue right now. We ain't talking about the peaches and the grapes and the oranges that happened that you threw out last 10 years ago. But we talking about the apple that we're dealing with today. Some folks go back and bring up all kind of stuff and got your home in an uproar.
Amen.
And you husbands, don't bring up things your wife done in the past. It's back there in the past. Leave it back there. Amen. And you got to come together. Hallelujah to God. Got to come together. How you going to heaven and you don't want to talk to your husband? How you going to heaven? You don't want to talk to your wife. You think God got a heaven on this side and one on that side? No way. It's one.
Amen.
Amen. But now the fruit of the Spirit, the first fruit is what? Then our people say, love it. Love! Let me tell you something. The Holy Ghost come with love. Hallelujah to God. Y'all got that in your Bible? The Holy Ghost come with love. Sure you've been hurt. Sure you've been scarred. Sure you've been abused. Amen. But you better repent and get it right. Hallelujah to God. And not only husband and wife, but sister and sister. Brother and brother. Sometimes sisters fall out. Sometimes brothers fall out. But you better fall back in. Because you ain't going to heaven without doing it right. Hallelujah to God. Now the fruit of the Spirit is love. The Holy Ghost come with love. Mere testimony.
Yes.
I said I enjoyed it. But if she home telling Brother Ron, I remember it.
Amen.
Every day, Mary out of her place.
Amen.
Yes. Somebody said, oh my Lord, she out of place. But she out.
Amen.
And if you doing it, you out of your place.
Amen.
And I'm not taking that back.
Amen.
You know, that's why people won't come up to God's standard. Because they want somebody to pat them. Well, I understand.
Yeah,
and stop going to them weak folks.
Amen.
If that was my husband, Mary, you know you ain't got no sense.
Well. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Amen.
If you got plenty of sense.
Amen.
You got God's sense.
Amen.
Sometimes people got common sense, but they ain't got no spiritual sense.
Amen.
They need some spiritual sense.
Amen.
Hallelujah to God. Because spiritual sense ain't gonna make you give somebody some bread when they give you some stone.
Yeah.
But common sense will tell you, I'm not doing it.
That's right.
Oh, yes. You need some spiritual sense.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
You know, sometimes people got books knowledge,
yeah,
but they ain't got no common sense.
Oh, yeah.
And sometimes that makes you come in the
house. Amen.
All right, here we go. All right, I'm almost finished. Something else. I can get to the point. Yeah, I got to get it all out of the way put in.
Yeah.
But this time around. Amen. Hallelujah to God.
Amen.
I got to get it all out. There's something still I ain't feeling. Yeah. When it's out, I'll sit down.
Yeah.
I ain't going to push 4 hours. And some of y'all saying, 4 hours, Lord, geez, you might try to do it today.
Amen.
No. I'll preach what the Holy Ghost give me.
Yeah.
Amen. But the fruit. If Mary's still bringing it up.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
It ain't right.
Amen.
Yeah.
She gave a good testimony.
Amen.
She said, love, turn that thing.
Hallelujah.
Love turned. I'm sure it wasn't easy on her. Y'all know that. You know, I'm not in that situation, but I'm telling you, I can feel that it will be, it won't feel good to me. Flesh will appreciate that. Y'all act like I'm all in that too. Let me tell you something. Some of y'all will do worse than what she did. Some of you do it worse. Yep, make hope it goes. But love, that I'm sure that didn't make her feel good. But she didn't go up there with a razor blade in her hand. She didn't go with a bat and say, I'm gonna bat that woman's head off. Some of you would go, there come on. Let me tell you something. You got to be in the spirit to do it God's way. And if you ain't doing it like that, you're not in the spirit.
Make it plain,
Elvis.
You got to be in the spirit.
That's right.
Amen.
You got to be in the spirit. I know a situation down there in the Denmark area where the man tied a woman behind his truck and dragged her. And a family went to the hospital and got her and said, but we take you home. And she said, no, I want to go home with my husband. Now he dragged her. And she ain't got no Holy Ghost.
Oh.
And she ain't had one.
Amen.
I'm talking about that time. They ain't got no Holy Ghost. I know some of y'all saying, hell, sit down back. And I ain't let no man drag me. I don't care how much Holy Ghost. I got the Holy Ghost and he dragged me. He better pray and kill me. Because that same truck he dragged me with, I'm going to run over him. Oh, yeah. This thing called love go deep.
Oh, yeah.
This thing go deep.
Oh, yeah.
These so-called love relationships go deep.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
When you love somebody, that thing can hurt you.
Yes.
You can have the Holy Ghost 10 times. And I tell somebody, you can have the Holy Ghost 10 times, if I come to you, bleed.
Oh, yes.
You still in the flesh.
Yes.
Sometimes some of these things hurt you.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Even then, it's too painful for me. You can be saved, but sometimes things hurt you. You can be sanctified, but sometimes things hurt you.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
True.
Amen. But you can't wall in that. Turn it loose and say, Lord, you got to fix this thing for me. I need you to fix it, Lord. What the Bible say here?
Yes, sir. Psalm
8,
chapter 6, verse.
Uh-huh.
Set me as a seal.
Set me as a seal.
Upon thine heart.
Upon thine heart.
As a seal upon thine arm.
Yes.
For love.
For love.
Is strong as death.
Amen.
Love strong as death. That's what the Bible, when you got that love. The Bible said that thing strong as death.
Amen.
You know, when death get a hold of you, you ain't coming back if God don't bring you back.
Amen.
God got to bring it from the dead. Love is as strong as death. Come on.
And jealousy is cruel as the grave.
Now watch that jealousy.
Oh yeah.
Amen.
Now watch jealousy.
Amen.
Jealousy is cruel.
And
some folks are jealous. The husband don't even let the wife breathe nobody. When sir is over, we'll get in the car till I get there.
Amen.
Some husband can't greet nobody but the brothers. They better not say praise the Lord to a sister.
Mm-mm.
Every sister you talk to, they get in the car, they're fussing about. Why do you have to talk to her?
Amen.
But on the other hand, you respect somebody's husband.
Amen.
Respect somebody's wife.
Amen.
That go a long way.
Yes.
Amen. Don't be up in people's face unnecessarily.
Yeah.
You can say that. Minister Webber always out doing things. But that don't mean you take advantage. He got to go to his wife sometime. But I thank God for Sister Dina. She got to share it. Somebody said, you don't see that about me. A lot of you, the brothers, be called upon. We thank God for your wives that can understand. But now, don't be calling them brothers for any little thing. To sweep the floor. I've got something on my floor.
Amen.
Want to move to your house. If you want a husband, ask God to give you your own husband.
Amen.
You want a wife, ask God to give you your own wife. Not anybody else on. You justify, if you qualify for a husband now. I'm not telling you got one. And don't want that one. Tell me, Lord, I want a husband. Because that thing I got now ain't got the first letter off husband. It ain't got the H. Well, if you married him, you just got a husband. He ain't got the H. Because he yours. You can say, but he's so weak. Well, you just got a weak man. You better pray and say, Lord, I need you full of strength. I'll tell you how to pray. I'll help you to pray. Tell me my part weak. I'll help you pray. Lord, he got a weak knee. I tell God, strengthen his knee, Lord. Because he yours. Amen. Yes, he yours. Some folks don't like this. He yours. I can't stand. And you know people ought not be saying that.
No.
I can't stand my husband. I can't stand my wife. They call them all kind of names. You out of the spirit. I shouldn't have married you. Too late for that. Some things not an option, and that's one of them. That's not an option. Throw it out the window. I don't like. That's why you need to wait on the Lord. You go after that flesh. Throw it after that flesh. Flesh won't see nothing but good times, feeling good. But when that water settles down, you got to live with that person. Yes, you do. You got to live with that person. When Sister Mac get home, and I take this black jacket off, take the tie off, shoes off, she got to live with Randy.
Amen.
You know what I'm talking about.
Amen.
You know some of us went away in church now.
Amen.
And we got to live with Ella, yep. As well as the evangelist. Mm-hmm. He's just sitting up there all full of power. He takes his jacket off, and puts him in the bedroom, sleeps on. She got to live with Ella.
Amen.
She got to live with his ways.
Amen.
Oh, yes.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
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 All y'all see, he looks so good in his suit. And you know what they, he looks so good standing up there holding his worship service. That's what I want.
Well,
I want that one. So when he stand up there and say, next sister. Do something to me. You seen that. But let me tell you something, that jacket got to come on.
That
shoe got to come on.
Yeah. Yeah.
I get up in the morning gag.
opportunity.
That's right.
You
guys.
And you say, wait a minute now. I don't understand. Blessing and curse are coming out the same power. Coming out the same fountain?
Oh, yeah.
Firstborn?
Yes, sir.
Coming out the same fountain?
Yes,
they in the church speaking these tongues?
Mm-hmm.
I want to thank God. I just love the people of God. At home, they want to snatch your hat off. Throw that food. Fuck them getting mad, snatch your white hat off. Throw it on. Put your foot on. You got the devil in you. Let me be one thing. You got the devil in you. That's right, I'm not scared of it.
That's right.
Yeah, right. I'm not taking that back. That's the devil.
Yes.
You know, I guess you said, Lord, I don't know. I got sense.
Amen.
You look at it, but you got to go live with them.
Yes.
All that time. Amen. You might look sick, but you don't want to be on the field.
Amen.
The phone ringing, and they look and see. Security finance.
I don't want to deal with no bill collectors. I can't stand bills. Let me tell you, if you don't got married, you got responsibilities. You gonna get a husband that don't want to pay no bills. And then tell you, well, the lights out, that's fine. We just have a camera light. And it's 15 degrees outside. What do you say you ain't got no heat? Can't say we're gonna pull up under the blanket, under the electric blanket, because you ain't got no electricity. They won't be blanket. Well, I know y'all think I'm crazy, but you know, this will help us now. This will help us. I'm getting ready to stop. This can help us.
Yeah.
It might look good.
That's it.
That sister might look good. Yeah. Always got a head covered. Mm-hmm. Eye in arms.
It's going to be home to get you.
That's right.
Oh, yes.
They home.
Yes.
Yeah.
Whatever you say. They say whatever you say to your man. Yeah, in the flesh, that the devil got you.
Oh, yeah,
amen. All right, give me what he gave me. Come on.
Is it jealousy?
Jealousy!
It's cruel as you bring.
All right.
Yeah.
It's cruel as you bring.
Amen. The coals thereof are coals of fire.
Yeah, coals of fire.
Which have a most vehement heat.
Hey, the whole word now. Hold the word. I give you what he gave me. Hold the word.
Yeah.
This to help us.
Yeah.
This to help us.
Thank you.
You know,
sink me in the gospel, the true hard gospel.
Oh, yeah.
You know, somebody say, I need something strong. I don't want no water. Sometimes you drink water, but sometimes you get that urge, you want something strong.
Oh, yeah.
Even if it hurts you, even if somebody preaching on you, you still need that strong thing.
Oh, yeah, you do.
Amen. Sometimes it might make you uncomfortable, but you can appreciate that strong gospel. Even if you don't know, oh, God, I ain't where I may need to be, but you need somebody to cry out and tell it like it is. It'll help your soul. It'll help your soul. All right. It'll help your soul. You that need God to wash you, tell God to wash you. You that need to be purged, ask Him to purge. You that need God to come in and clean you up, amen, let Him do it. So you can have joy and gladness. So you can get that joy. So you can feel God moving in you and through you. And the song said, I can feel God stretching out in me.